Okay, so when it comes to the engine heads on, it's torqued down. I put some sealant on this water neck. I put some sealant on that little cover there. And I put sealant on the oil pump. Oil pump's one you can see nicely. I put sealant around it. However, I did not put anything around the water pump. Also the sump. I do believe I might have to take it off again. But what I'm going to do is first see where it leaks, see if it leaks. It's probably going to leak. These D-series oil pans really like to leak, especially around this half moon area. So yeah, I'll see where it leaks and then take it off. My problem is just if I seal it, use the sealant on it now and it leaks, then I have to take everything off again. So I thought to myself, let's first build everything, see if it leaks without any sealant, so then I can just take it off, clean it up with a rag very easily, and then put sealant on it later. So this cover did clean up fairly nicely. It is a bit slightly damaged here and there. You can see there's some stains, especially around these contact areas where the bolts go. There's a lot of yellowing and cracks and hardening of the plastic going on. But luckily you won't see this bottom part of it. You basically will only see, once this is in the car, you'll basically see this section here. And this part looks... doesn't look too bad. It goes nicely with the new clean block compared to what this was. So we'll be putting this cover back on here just to make sure that these timing marks are correct, and then I'll put the other one on as well. You guys will find out later why. Biggest reason for these covers, most people probably don't run them, they just leave them off. But I mean, if you have this cover off and you have your pulley here, your pulley will possibly cover this area here, and you get a rock in here, and that rock basically, while this belt rotating, goes in here, this might snap your cam belt, and you know, so it's just for a bit more reliability. Okay, so I put that cover on, and you can see where it says P28 and it has this little arrow here. It doesn't really line up here, but then if you check here, we have the P08 mark on the pulley, the P08 mark on the pulley, and they now basically line up perfectly. However, this one does not line up, and that's actually good because I didn't know that. If I was going to set this just as a normal one, I wouldn't have used these P08 little markings, and I was going to set it on this and have these two lines line up with the head. Also this says up here, just so you know which side is up. But yeah, so you know, you learn something every day. So I put this little screw in here. It has this little collar on it, which goes in there and then basically makes sure that this thing is exactly in place where it should be. So I'm pretty sure that these marks are now in the right place. And the timing is now, well, the cam timing is set. Obviously on this one there's a different mark. We have this little arrow here, and you have this tiny mark on the pulley, like that small mark there. And that must line up with this. It is slightly off, but the problem is this pulley has a little bit of wear in there. So you can see this, I think this crank pulley and stuff has come loose in the past. This is a thing with these Hondas. Because people don't have that tool to lock the pulley, so they can't torque this thing up to whatever it wants. I think it wants like 130 newtons or something like that. So we have the covers fitted, and you guys can see on this engine, the D15Z4, this is actually a dipstick tube and it goes into the oil pump. You know, some of them go in here, some go in like the B series in the middle, but this thing basically, it's a loose tube. I can pull it out so it clips onto this cover here, so therefore you have to run this cover, otherwise this tube will just, like, it can turn around and come out and whatever. So you have to run this cover on the side. I cleaned up this mount thinking that it's the mount I need, and then I noticed that when I tried to put the cover on it didn't fit, and it turns out there's two mounts. There's this one with a slightly smaller and a different design, slightly lighter than, feels slightly lighter, this one, but yeah, this is the one that goes on the newer engine and with the newer cover. And obviously that cover doesn't fit on here. Other than that, there's no difference. These pegs are in the same spot, bolts up the same. However, this one is, I think, a bit better designed. Guys, it's the next day, finally getting somewhere. Valve covers on, even though it's just on there to keep dust out for now. Working on this pulley now. This keyway that they actually, the hole they made in this pulley is too big, so the notch that goes into this keyway is too big. If you look at this one, the notch is like very small. This is obviously a correct pulley, but it's very damaged. So the notch is very small, and then if you come here, that notch is huge. So now you actually need a different shape. Keyway, no, it's not a keyway, it's basically a key. Now you need a different shape key. And the problem with that is you can buy them from Honda for like 50 bucks, and then they don't really fit in there. So it sits in here loose. So what I decided to do is to take an Allen key and a file and just make my own. So I basically just grinded down the Allen key progressively until it fits. And I think it fits now. Okay, well, not that way around. Yeah, and there it goes. So now it's basically in there. So what I'm going to do is just cut it off. You have to cut it off a bit shorter because you don't want it to push into the that little guide that keep the cambelt on. You don't want it to push into that. You also don't want it to stick out further than this lip, because if it does, the bolt will actually tighten down onto the keyway and not onto the pulley. And if that happens, eventually this will come loose and you'll sit with this problem. So yeah, I know from experience I've had a lot of trouble with these things. So yeah, very sensitive, very important, and always Loctite and torque this bolt to the proper spec. If this thing comes loose, it will damage your crank. I don't know if anyone can see, but this crank is already damaged very slightly, especially right there on the corner. The corner is very damaged. Still usable. The other engine I had was even worse than this, and I was still managed to use it as well. Okay, so I cut it off and rounded the corners neatly, and this is what we have. Perfectly sized steel key made from a Allen key. I know some people might say this thing needs to be like keyway steel or super hardened steel, but in my opinion, if this is the softest between the pulley and the crank, obviously if something goes wrong, the softest material is going to fail first. And you don't want the key to stay intact, but the pulley and the crank to be destroyed. So I'd far rather have the pulley and the keyway be destroyed than the crank. So in my opinion, this is obviously not like hardened steel or anything. This wasn't one of those black Allen keys. It was just a normal cheap Allen key that I have two of the same. So this should work just fine. And if it comes loose, you want the key to fail, not the crank. Okay, so I rotated the engine a few times. These are the marks I made on this pulley because it doesn't come with marks. Of course it doesn't. I did try a few times, but I know this one furthest back is the correct one. And you can see it lines up with the little sight Honda gives you. And then if you go up here, you can see the marks. The P08 mark lines up with the one on the pulley. Same with the one on the other side. The P08 one lines up. And there it is. Now the engine is timed. I still need to torque this bolt and torque the cam bolt. But yeah, progress are being made. I was working on the gearbox the other day. I replaced the seal. It looks dirty because I drained all this oil out of there. Also changed this seal. The only one I'm waiting for now is this one. I ordered it from Honda. I think that's like a Honda only part. Kind of looks like this. So it's like a big, it's almost like a bushing and a seal all in one. This thing, anyone who's tried to take this thing out knows what this thing's called, and for good reason. I got it out by using this bolt. I basically see this bolt fits nicely in there, so I just hammered it out with this bolt. But while you hammer it out, don't just hammer it out with no support, because you might bend this rod. So I actually use this CV cup just to support this part. So while I'm hitting it, all the force doesn't go into the shaft, so you don't bend that shaft. We'll be right back. ton of progress. I didn't film all of it just because there's a lot of small things, very repetitive. But I mean, we got the valve cover on. We have these nice dress-up bolts. This Mugen oil filler cap with real carbon fiber. I got a clear pulley cover and I modified it so you can remove this cover without actually taking the valve cover off, because normally you can't. So this one's modified. You can just unbolt these two bolts and take this cover off so you can either clean it or adjust the cam gear. But yeah, here's the gearbox. This took very, very long to get this clean and perfect. I repainted this gearbox about 2 years ago, and then ever since that, it just sat in my garage. And it, you know, it kind of got some oil on it for some reason, not sure how, and some of the paint got damaged, and here and there, there was some damage on the paint. But I just gave it a light sand and repainted it, and it came out perfect again. I put all the best brackets and bolts and the nicest little switches. The other one had a little tear in the plastic. Also, I put the speed sensor in here that I know works. Look how clean the inside of this thing is.